We have automation at the top of our heads. Hans talked about the machine brain, about TwinCAT being the machine brain. And I would like to discuss this matter a little bit more in detail with Josef and Johannes. Thank you for joining us today. We started with TwinCAT in 1996, Josef. What did happen since then?
So when we started in 1996, the complete software development was sitting in one room. Now we have about 300 software developers sitting in a part of our building. So it's, of course, increasing more people, but of course also we had more and more features. When we started, we had PLC and motion control mainly, and now we have a lot of different features, vision, machine learning, and all of this stuff. We are working inside the software development in small teams responsible for one or more products. So it's very defined teams of experts. And we are working with the Scrum methodology and with Azure DevOps as a tool.
Okay, so many, many small teams who are then still in one room again, but many rooms these days.
Many rooms, of course.
And everything in East Westphalia, it fails.
Yeah. Yes, so. And we have also a stable people, employees, so they are.
You're part of them, yeah.
I'm part of this, of course, since 27 years, but also the first developers are also on board. Yeah. But of course, we have a lot of new employees, new people coming into the company, and so you have old, experienced people, but also the new, young people.
Yeah, and you need the mix also for covering, for example, new technologies such as machine learning.
Yes, of course.
Johannes, if I would now come to our booth and I would ask you, tell me about the most important features of TwinCAT. What would you come up with?
The one and only software to do automation control with. No. One software to rule them all. But not to bind them into the dark. But however, TwinCAT is our central software where we do, in the back of portfolio, where we do automation control with, so where we control with the machine. So each and every aspect of the machine is programmed and controlled by TwinCAT. And doesn't matter if it's PLC programming, if it's even MATLAB simulating programming, safety programming, HMI, complex motion, normal motion, image processing, all of that is done in the same software environment, so TwinCAT is very powerful. And because, and it consists out of many, many modules, because each functionality here is one software module which can be imported or which can be implemented into TwinCAT, and then you can do whatever you want to do with it.
Doing all of these calculations seems to be like a task which really requires modern PC technology. How do we handle this?
Complex machines, of course, they require some computational power. And this is why TwinCAT, since the beginning of TwinCAT 3, can do many core calculations. So we really can use each and every one of our CPU cores. We have, for example, on our industrial IPCs. Utilize it to run TwinCAT on there. So you can, for example, spread your PLC on two cores, on two CPU cores. You can spread your motion among four cores, safety among several cores, and so on. So we can really utilize many, many machines. You know that from the Xplanar, there we are using TwinCAT on more than 40 cores, actually, in order to run the Xplanar and other parts of the machine. So this is really powerful.
But it goes all the way up, from the very small ARM-based CPU for a few hundred euros to the very big processors. Huh?
Exactly. Doesn't matter if it's that little guy or a small ARM controller or a CX7000 or big CPUs like this year, our C6030 with an Intel Core i7 or even i9 in them. TwinCAT runs on all of them. And it's the same environment where our customers do the programming and also where the runtime runs. So the TwinCAT is, you really have to think of it as a software. It's not hardware dependent, and it's also not operating system dependent. So of course TwinCAT, we started with Windows, because TwinCAT is also the abbreviation for the Windows Control Automation Technology. But nowadays TwinCAT can also run on Linux, on BSD, and that means TwinCAT is a software independent, more or less, from the operating system and also from the hardware.
I think that's something which you have to let sink in a little bit, because since many, many years, you can turn with TwinCAT an ordinary computer into a machine controller, especially with the real-time capabilities. Virtual PLC is a hot topic on this fair. What's our point on this?
You just said that. You can run TwinCAT on a laptop or on a server, and all of a sudden you can real-time control. That means virtual PLC. That's an inherent functionality of TwinCAT, which we had all the years where we did not have to change anything, because we can simply let TwinCAT run on a server. We also show that here on the trade show, and then we can do real-time control through a switch network on the machine through a server. So virtual PLC, no problem at all.
We got you covered there. Josef, one last topic. 300 people doing software development in many different groups. They are producing new features, new software basically every week. How can we make this available to our customers?
So of course, we can make it available because we have automatic processes. So if someone is changing a software, it's automatically generated, the software compiled. Then it's tested and then it's packed into a package. And then it's available for customers. So we have many, many packages with different software. And this is all available for our customers in our new TwinCAT 4026. So customers can use in a very early stage new functionalities in the package. So they can install this, they can test it, they can give feedback. But they get also updates, bug fixes or new features. Also on the way with packages.
So machine development becomes also more dynamic because we are supplying more functionalities in a more dynamic way. And we are very, very lucky to have a customer with us today. Thank you, you two.
We need the TwinCAT expert because I think, Felix, we have questions of TwinCAT PLC++, right?
Yeah, it's actually about a question about the history of TwinCAT
PLC++. Okay, let's go.
Josef. A nice technology, well accepted, many people, many competitors coming around, having a look at it. When did we start working on it?
We started about 8 years ago with a small team, so it's a one-man team.
Okay.
And so it's now a team of 10 people working on this.
It has grown over time.
It has grown, of course.
And when will it be available? Do you have plans
It will
for
be
that?
Available next year, end of next year.
Wonderful.
So on the SBS show next year, we will have a release.
Okay, perfect. In the package management, I guess,
yes? Yes, of course. Yeah, of course.
Wonderful. Thank you, Josef, again.